Hello everyone, a very good afternoon. Thank you for joining us. My name is Richa Khosla. I work with IDP Education as a Canada Destination Expert. Thank you for being patient. I know you guys are very curious about Canada application. Specifically, this session is conducted for students who are quite apprehensive about their application process for an undergrad degree in Canada. All we know is Canada is about diplomas, certificates, advanced diplomas, PG certificates, but there are a lot of opportunities available in degree. Did you guys ever knew that there are top universities in Canada that offers highly competitive programs? At the same time, their demand, the opportunities that they give are extremely wide. So I'll take you through one of these things. I'll show you how Canada is very important and the bachelor degree that they offer will open a wide horizon for you guys. So I would request you, in case if you have any questions, I'll take it up at the end of the session. So over here, we will be discussing about why you should study a degree in Canada. How, what is the duration? When we meant duration, duration is specifically in terms of how many years of degree, a bachelor degree is in Canada. What are the specializations that Canada offers? Secondly, what is the difference between a degree and a diploma? So how a Canadian degree is popular in Canada and how it is different from the degrees that are offered by other destinations. What is the difference between a UG a major, UG minor, ranking, admissions requirement? What are the scopes? When is the right time to apply for a Canadian application for a degree program? What is the fee? What are the job opportunities and post-study work permit rights? So for a bachelor degree in Canada, Canada has a very specific understanding. So they accept 10 plus 2 plus 4 year of education. When we say 10 plus 2 plus 4, in India, we have class 10th. And post that, we have 2 years of secondary education, which is class 11th and 12th. So in Canada, unlike India, the bachelor degree is for 4 years. Hence, the education is always 10 plus 2 plus 4. When we say the quality of education offered by the university, the program, the infrastructure, the research facilities at the university offers are highly world-class. The faculty members are quite encouraging. They have a lot of professors and research materials and labs that are there within the university. To have that kind of exposure to the students, they try to ensure that they have all the facility available within the premises. The students are allowed to have a hang-on on the labs and other processes, and lots of other opportunities are there. There are practical exposure to the program that is involved and offered by a Canadian university. Did you guys ever knew that when you are enrolled in a university, so there are a lot of opportunities available with a degree, as in you can gain a lot of work experience. Meanwhile, so there are internships. So internships can be on campus or they can be off campus. At the same time, there are certain courses that allow and give you an opportunity of co-op or co-op-based program. You would have come across a lot about a program offering co-op in Canada. Of course, we all are new. We all have our own understanding in case if we want to go outside. What are the working options? What are the part-time opportunities available? All the international students are allowed to work up to 20 hours per week and 40 hours during their vacations. So how a degree is different from a diploma? Did you guys ever knew that a bachelor degree, what is the basic difference? So usually a bachelor degree is offered by a university. There are few colleges that have started offering degree programs, yes. But diplomas and advanced diplomas are mostly offered by colleges. Other than that, did you know that a degree program is more research oriented? They have a lot of value added to it. Have you ever guys knew that a diploma and an advanced diploma are basically practical courses, as in they offer you, they give you skill knowledge about the opportunities that are available. They are professional courses, unlike a bachelor degree, which is very quantitative in sense. There are a lot of research oriented programs. They are offered in different fields of education, like science, humanities, arts, history, engineering, IT. Of course, diploma and advanced diploma are also offered in these different fields. Other than that, diplomas are basically, they enable a student, an international student, and they give opportunity to get a hand on a skill program. However, a degree program is always a two-year program. A diploma and an advanced diploma is for 2 to 3 years. The tuition fee varies from university to university. So the minimum, the general tuition fee when we say for a university is $26,000. However, there are universities that also offered a degree program for 1 year can also be somewhere around $18,000 to, which can go up to $35,000 to $40,000. Whereas a diploma and an advanced diploma tuition fee is $15,000. Also, one more thing, in case why we should opt for a bachelor degree. So the question remains that. So in case if you have completed a degree program, there the opportunity will be more, of course. Later when you are doing a diploma in Canada or in an advanced diploma, you always have to, for a higher salary package, for a higher growth opportunity, you have to go and complete your degree to gain and to have more opportunities available in Canada. So it's highly recommendable for students who are quite eligible to opt for a bachelor degree. Of course, there are apprehensions that the degree programs are expensive. For your information, the university offers a lot of scholarships. We will talk more about those scholarships. And once the student gets those scholarships and the co-op opportunities and the internship opportunities, the fee structure comes out to be a similar that a diploma or an advanced diploma is offering. So, rankings. In Canada, usually, it does not fall under any ranking. However, top university falls under some of the universities. So in case if any of your parents, any of your students, any of the students out there, they want to check on the university's ranking, they can check on McLean, which is Canadian ranking system. Also, much of the institutions in Canada do not fall under the ranking, because to fall under any ranking, there is a parameter that they should have a degree and a master's program available within university. And there are other more parameters for which they need to fall under any ranking. So most of the institution do not, but the top ranked universities in Canada, which offer bachelor degree, are under the top 200 ranking, like University of Alberta, Toronto, Waterloo, University of British Columbia, McMaster, University of Ottawa. These are the few universities that fall under the top 200 world ranking. So what are the admissions requirements in Canada for a bachelor program? So most of the universities in Canada, so of course in Canada, getting into a university is a little competitive, but when a student has minimum of class 12, they give minimum of 70% in class 12, they will be eligible for good and top universities. And those are not private institutions, though these are fully government universities in Canada. Other than that, IELTS is minimum 6 with no section less than 6. However, few programs for a bachelor degree also. So I wanted to emphasize on the fact that certain programs in literature, political science, related to nursing, medicine, biochemistry, biotechnology, these sort of programs do require a higher IELTS, which can go up to 6.5 and 7.5 with no section less than 6. However, also remember that there are few universities like University of Toronto, University of Waterloo, University of Ottawa, University of British Columbia, York University. For these universities, the minimum, and even University of Saskatchewan, for some of these universities, they want a higher IELTS for most of their programs. Like University of Waterloo, their minimum requirement for most of their programs is 7 or 7.5 with no section less than 7. unlike any other destination, like most of the universities based out of Europe or USA, where they require ACTs and SAT, Canadian university, a bachelor degree does not require an ACT or a SAT. So only 10 plus 2 plus 4 with your class 10th scorecard, your 12th predicted score, your IELTS scorecard, you can very well put an application for any university based in Canada. But for most of the programs in Canada would require maths. Yes, most of the programs in Canada would require maths. For instance, programs related to IT, programs related to engineering, business will require maths, but programs related to hospitality or something into international business, arts, even literature, these sort of culinary programs, these sort of programs do not require maths. For engineering related program, it is highly recommended that the student should have physics, chemistry, maths, and English in class 12. These are the combinations that they would be, the university would be wanting the student to have. For instance, a student wants to apply for applied mathematics. So the bachelor's of applied mathematics, which are very popular in University of Saskatchewan, they would be wanting student to have physics and maths both. Of course, English is very well there in class in all our schools. For most of the programs related to arts and designing, they would require a portfolio. So portfolio is a part of application which is related to programs like which are offered by NSCAD, OCAD, these sort of universities, where bachelors of fine arts are one of the, or designing related program, they require portfolio. So these universities have their own parameters how to submit a portfolio. To submit a portfolio, they would be wanting a written piece or your sketching or your designs, but you need to, how you need to send, every institution has their own ways. Once you have submitted the application, you will be getting a generated link that you need to upload your portfolio by this. So once again, what are documents that we require? Class 10th, of course, passport. Without passport, IELTS would not be, you cannot book your IELTS. So IELTS would be required. Other than that, maths for most of the institution, for most of the program, maths is required. But yes, we know that some of our students in India, we also drop their maths after class 10. So for those students, we always recommend those students to take another maths test or to have a maths test done within India. In case if they do not, they need to have another maths. They should opt on a maths as a credit once they reach to the university. Predicted score would be required. A predicted score should be on the letterhead of the school. So how is a little different, how a degree is different in Canada as an Indian education degree. So we follow grade system. We have mark system. In Canada, we have credit system. So in a year, student basically earns 30 credits when they enroll for a bachelor degree. So how many credits? 30 credits. So when is the right time to apply for an application in Canada? So most of the institutions in Canada usually start their application with August and September. But for a university applications, most of the applications are started by October or November. There are few universities that have, so most of the bachelor's program, all the bachelor's program are available for fall, spring. Spring is a very limited intake where we have few universities open with limited programs for a bachelor degree. Summer, which is a May intake, there are a handful number of universities that open up and they have limited programs for an undergrad degree. So in case if you guys are planning to apply, so what my suggestion to you is that the ideal time for a student to apply for a Canadian degree, for a Canadian university, for a bachelor degree, they should meet their counselors or they should start doing their preparation for a candidate application, and they should meet their counselors by at least by June, July, so that they debrief about the whole application process. By October, they are ready with their IELTS scorecard. They're also ready with their predicted score, their 10 mark sheet, and their passport. Everything is ready, because the applications for all the universities start by October and November. Also, it is highly recommendable, since Canadian universities are quite competitive in their application process and their admissions requirement. So it is highly recommendable that you apply as early as possible. The sooner you apply, the better are the chances of you getting admitted to a university. So most of the universities which are based in Ontario, Ontario-based university, their application goes through OUAC portal. It's Ontario University Application System. So basically for OUAC application, an international student should apply through 105F. So you can apply maximum to three universities. The application fee for OUAC is $150 Canadian. In case if you want to add on more university or more program, you need to pay additional $50 Canadian for per university or per course. Of course, once you have submitted the application, you need to pay the application fee. But university based out of, other than Ontario, in other provinces like British Columbia, Alberta, they have again their application usually goes through their portal or through Apply Alberta or Education Planner BC. The application process and the documentation remains the same irrespective of the institution which is based out of, in whichever province. So what my suggestion is that the minimum application for a university is $150 Canadian. Minimum, I say it ranges between $100 to $150 Canadian. So in case if you want to apply as soon as possible, be ready with your documents so that as early as you apply, you get the admission and the offer letter. So application for OUAC, I was mentioning about OUAC because most of the institutions that are based in Ontario, specifically towards university like Lakehead, Brock, Toronto, University of Ottawa, Nipissing, Toronto Metropolitan University, Carleton University, these sort of university, their application goes through OUAC, even Windsor. So the application starts by the month in the October and November, all the programs are available. The deadline to apply for September, which is the fall intake, is 1st of March, $150 Canadian for three universities I have mentioned earlier. 105F is the application portal where in OUAC, where we submit application for international student. So of course, there is a lot of myths about that the bachelor degree is expensive in Canada. Few universities, their application, their tuition fee is quite high and competitive. Do agree with that. But mostly all the institutions and the universities in Canada have a similar sort of fee. Of course, there are certain programs which have different fee structure or a little higher fee structure, or some universities have a higher fee structure like Waterloo, Ottawa, not Carleton, Toronto, UBC, York, they have higher fee structure, agreed. But then university like Toronto Metropolitan, Brock University, Lakehead, Carleton, University of Saskatchewan, University of Manitoba, University of Windsor, these all prestigious universities have similar fee structure, and to meet and cater the demand of the students so that it becomes Financially, it is very well easily available for the students. They offer scholarships. So scholarships are based on merit. For instance, a student has at least 75 to 80%, they would be offered with a merit-based scholarship. And those merit-based scholarships usually starts from $1,000 Canadian and can range up to $3,000 Canadian, but it depends from from the percentage of the student that he has got in class 12. Then there is provisional government scholarship. Of course, provisional government scholarship, grants, bursaries, tuition fee waivers, or Commonwealth scholarship, and private and organization scholarships are offered to very limited and selected students. They can apply for these. They need to submit the application to the university once they are enrolled, and they can, at the same time, they can apply for these scholarships. And in case if they get the government bodies, the bursaries and the colleges that are offered by and Commonwealth scholarship, these are intimated to the student that you have been selected. Of course, the parameters and the selection criteria are very, very high and competitive. Merit-based scholarships are widely available by all the universities. At the same time, as I have mentioned, co-op opportunities and internship opportunities are there, which makes the tuition fee as similar to a college program. So I have been talking about a lot about co-op in Canada. What is co-op? So co-op is basically a practical work experience that the is accompanied and is somehow inculcated with the program in a way that the student gain work experience. And at the same time, once they are learning and they are graduating from the university. So co-op programs are available with most of the engineering, IT, and even with some of the business and hospitality programs. So these co-op programs are once, so the student will be working with real organizations. When we say real, they will be working with real organizations. The co-op programs are approved by government. So when I say approved, so government bodies actually work out on the curriculum and they see that the co-op is particularly inculcated and is embedded in the curriculum in such a way that it helps the student to get a job also later. So most of the students who are quite connected and with their professors or with these companies also at the time of graduation, when they graduate from the universities, they also get adapted and absorbed by these industries itself only. But so every student, if a student applies for co-op, definitely they would be given a co-op option. But at the same time, the student has to maintain certain percentage in the class, certain sort of grade in GPA, CGPA in first year, so that there they get the co-op in the second year. So in Canada, co-op are very well available and easily available with most of the programs and are very well available in most of the universities. How it is important and beneficial for an international student is that it makes the fee structure very nominal. I won't say nominal, but at least students get hang of it. At the same time, they gain practical work experience and exposure to the company. The engineers and IT students get absorbed very quickly in case if they have done their co-op in the program itself only. Also, we all know that Canada shares 4 borders with US, and most of the IT companies have their base or headquarters based out of America, USA, North America. So it becomes, and some of the companies also and the universities also have tie-up for certain programs based in US as well during for co-op. So co-op is very well, makes the student more and more aggressive and more educated once they are doing it. So the course is always updated and the curriculum is designed in such a way that it meets the demand of the current market, and so does the co-op. So every year they work on the curriculum and the co-op that the company they are working with so that the student gets the benefit out of it. So co-op is actually structured in a way that it is basically combined with the class-based education. At the same time, the student get the work experience. So the component, so how the co-op work is that the work experience of the program is basically 50% of the program. For instance, you have 50% the course. In total, the course, the 50% of the course will be, it should not be more than 50% of the course. That is the way co-op works. So usually an average that a student earns in a week during, if he or she gets enrolled on a co-op program, is 563 Canadian dollar per week. So also one more thing. So not everybody can work for a co-op. They should have applied for a co-op as well with their valid study permit at the time of applying for the student visa. So co-op and internship should not be more than 50% of their total study. And co-op is available at most of the UG degrees. So a student spends 4 months as an international student, full-time student, and then 4 months of the working with the co-op is designed in such a way that the remaining 4 months is their course, and the 4 months is basically their work experience or their internship or co-op. So usually how much does a student earn during a co-op in a term? Is basically somewhere between 30,000 to 40 to 45,000. Some co-op programs are paid more, which can go up to 50,000 also. Of course, these numbers can vary a little bit, but these are the tentative figures and the wages that we have. We are well aware, and the students usually earn during the co-op opportunities. So what are the post-study work opportunities that are available? Specifically in Canada. So student can with a, so as we have said that the bachelor degree in Canada is for 4 years. So with 4 years of education, student get up to 3 years of post study work permit, right? So we always recommend, we see, of course, Canadian government says that the student gets 3 years of work experience, but it depends on the length of the program. So it's usually up to 3 years, but with a bachelor degree, the chances are always higher to get 3 years of post-study work permit. So with 1 year of education, you get with 1 year of post-study work permit, two years or more of course program duration, of course the student gets up to 3 years of post-study work permit. This was from my end, but of course I wanted to highlight on some of the popular programs that are offered in Canada specifically. When we say popular programs, the bachelor programs are quite popular. Most of the institution, all the institutions offer all the programs in all the diverse fields, like bachelor in business. We have international business, marketing, finance, accounting. All these programs are accredited and have CPA or very well have their own accreditations. Other than that, in IT, we have mechanical, automotive, aerospace, all other sort of engineering. In IT, we have information technology, information security system, big data sciences, data analysis, cloud computing. In maths, we have a practical mathematical engineering. In physics, we have science and physics, health sciences, all sort of programs, culinary, hospitality management, business administration, business and computer administration. We have environmental energy, sustainable energy, bachelor of sustainable energy program. All sort of programs are available in Canada. Other than that, the universities, like specifically when we say University of Carleton, it is very popular for engineering, IT, and business-related and journalism-related program. When we talk about other universities like Lakehead, it's located. The location of the university is fabulous. It's in Thunder Bay, 2 hours away from Toronto. In case if the student has graduated or done with their bachelor degree from Lakehead University, Being in Thunder Bay, the student gets an opportunity to for a provision nomination program as well. They can apply for Express PR because Thunder Bay falls under the provisional nomination category as well. Other than that, Windsor. So University of Windsor share the border. So Windsor itself is located in Guelph. So Guelph is a place which is on the border of Detroit. Detroit is a place in US where all the automotive and mechanical, top mechanical companies have their base in Canada. So most of the graduates from University of Windsor gets hired and absorbed by General Motors, Mercedes, BMW. University of Saskatchewan is very popular with the agro-based and agriculture and food processing courses. These sort of universities have all programs. Queen's University, which is a very popular and fall under the top 13, top 15 universities in Canada, is very popular for health and kinesiology programs. Other universities like Brock, which is very popular, it's located in Niagara, where Niagara Falls is there. There are a lot of programs available in all the fields, you name it, like music also they have business, they have engineering, computers, IT, all sort of programs are available, but at the same time, they offer a high amount of scholarship. Laurentian University, which is very, again, popular for their mining courses or environmental and sustainability program, industrial engineering related programs. Thompson River University, which is very popular for trade and hospitality program or program related to business analytic or IT diploma, IT engineering. So all the universities have all program. You just name it. Canada is a diverse country with all programs available. The best part with them is that the universities are highly ranked at the same time. And most of these universities are fully government-funded universities. They are research-based universities. And the visa success rate with all the institutions are very, very extremely high. So students, why to wait? No ACTs, no SATs are required for a Canadian bachelor degree. Just your passport and IELTS, valid IELTS scorecard, 10th mark sheet, 12th predicted score, and you can very well apply for a university in Canada for a bachelor program. For right now, it's highly time to talk to your parents about the availability and scope of programs and opportunities available. There are a lot and lot of career opportunities available in Canada once you have graduated. The graduate employment rate is at least 94 to 95% for every university. I hope my suggestion and my key message to you guys has been delivered, that a degree program is as equal and as beneficial doing a diploma in Canada.